We'd like to take the derivative of a function raised to another function. In this case, it's a very simple x raised to the x, but it could be something more complicated, like sine raised to the cosine. So how can we take a derivative like this? We can't use the x to a number rule, the power rule, because we don't have a number up here in the top. We can't use the a to the x rule, because even though we have an a in the top, we don't have a number in the bottom. So neither one of these is going to work. We need to come up with something completely new. And what we're going to do is we're going to end up doing logarithmic differentiation. So we're going to take the log of both sides. And now we can use that log rule that we talked about before. Log of a to the b equals b log a. To bring down the ax that's in this exponent to in front of the log. Now, this looks a little bit like the power rule, so make sure you don't get confused. This is a log rule from pre-calculus, as opposed to the power rule, which gives you n x to the n minus 1, and that's a derivative. This here is not taking a derivative, it's just doing an algebraic manipulation. So we have natural log of y equals x times natural log of x. Now we know how to take the derivative of natural log of y, we know how to take the derivative of x, we know how to take the derivative of natural log of x, so we can do d dx of both sides. The derivative of natural log of y is 1 over y times dy dx. And the derivative of x times natural log of x, we need to use the product rule. So the derivative of x is 1 times natural log of x unchanged plus x unchanged times the derivative of natural log of x, which is 1 over x. Now, we can solve for dy dx. So we have natural log of x plus, notice that x over 1 times 1 over x is just 1. So natural log of x plus 1 times y. And then our last step when doing logarithmic differentiation is to replace that y with the original function. So replacing the y with x to the x, we've now taken the derivative of x to the x. And so anytime you have a function raised to a function, you're going to have to use logarithmic differentiation. When you're using logarithmic differentiation to make a really complicated function simpler, that's a choice. You really could use the product rule and the quotient rule and the power rule as many times as you need to. But whenever you have a function raised to a function, like sine of x to the cosine of x, this is the only way to do this problem. So again, what would we do? We would write y equals sine of x to the cosine of x, and we want to take the natural log of both sides. Now there's another way of actually notating this, and so I'm going to show you this in this problem. Instead of actually taking natural log of both sides and using implicit, I'm going to take e raised to the ln of sine of x to the cosine of x. And the advantage of this is that it doesn't use implicit differentiation, and we can actually do it in the middle of a more complicated problem, like the one I'm going to show you in just a minute. So what does this do for us? Well, now we've got y equals e, and we have l of something raised to something, so we can use that power rule and bring it down. So we have cosine of x times natural log of sine of x. So now what? Well, now we have something that's complicated looking, but it's something that we can do with just the chain rule and the product rule and the chain rule again. So taking the derivative here, the outsidemost thing is e. So e to the something is that something times the derivative of the something, so now we're going to need to use the product rule because we have two things being multiplied here, cosine and natural log of sine of x. So we have the derivative of cosine, which is negative sine, times the natural log of sine unchanged, plus, running out of room here, so I'm going to go below, cosine unchanged times the derivative of natural log of sine of x. Now remember, the derivative of natural log is 1 over, so we get 1 over sine of x times the derivative of sine of x because of the chain rule, so cosine of x. So there, we have taken the derivative of sine raised to the cosine of x, We've used the trick of a log to bring down the exponent, but we haven't had to do implicit differentiation. And we've still been able to find the answer. Let's try one more example. This is x raised to the natural log of x plus 8x squared. And this is an example like what I was referring to in the last problem, where you have something where you're going to need the log, and a function raised to a function, but it's inside the context of a bigger problem. So here, how would you do this? You would write f of x equals e raised to the natural log of, now here's our function raised to a function, x to the ln of x, plus 8x squared. So now the fact that we have the 8x squared there doesn't really hamper us at all. As opposed to, if you tried to do the natural log of both sides here, if you had y equals x to the ln of x plus 8x squared, and you take natural log of both sides of that, now we can't actually apply that log rule. We can't bring this out front because it's not, the whole thing inside the log is not raised to that power. As soon as you have a plus sign inside of a log like that, you can't use any more rules, log rules, to simplify it. So this doesn't work at all. So down here, back to our e to the ln way of dealing with this. Now this makes sense to do, right? Because e and ln undo each other. So we really haven't done anything to this function. X to the ln of x is the same as e to the ln of x to the ln of x. So now we can just use regular derivative rules to take the derivative of this equation as soon as we rewrite it one more time. So the thing we need to do still is to take this ln and bring it out front. So we get e, this ln up out front, times, and then the ln that was left from before, which was just ln of x, so that's kind of confusing. We have ln of x times ln of x, plus our 8x squared. And now we're just going to go straight to f prime using our regular derivative rules, product, quotient, chain. No implicit is needed. So the derivative of e to the something is e to that something. This is e to the ln of x, the whole thing squared, because there's two of them, right, multiplied together. And note, again, you can't use the natural log rule of bringing down a power on this one, because the 2 was outside of the log. It's not inside the log. So we have e to the natural log of x squared times the derivative of natural log of x squared. So that's times 2 natural log of x, because the outsidemost function here is something squared, so it's 2 to the first power. But now I have to take the derivative of that inside. So the derivative of natural log of x is 1 over x. So we've done two chain rules here. Actually, the derivative of e to the something is e to that something times the inside there, natural log of to the second power becomes 2 natural log to the first power. But now I have to take the derivative of natural log and we get 1 over x. And now we're going to add to that the derivative of 8x squared, which is just 16x. And so there we go. There's a using the power of logs to take a derivative of a function raised to a function added to some other function.